Inside Morehead State Basketball is brought to you by Jack Rowe Insurance, your independent agent serving all your insurance needs. The Citizens Bank of Morehead, the home of totally free checking. Larry Fannin Chevrolet, Buick, and GMC. Richard White Wood Products, a premier exporter of Kentucky hardwoods worldwide. Lakeside Christian Academy, located on US 60 West in Morehead. Educating for eternity. Visit us online at lakesidechristianacademy.org. Standifer Builders Paving and Sealing of West Liberty. Professional work at low prices. That's how we roll. The Tim Short Auto Group. Take the short drive to satisfaction. Northcutt and Son Home for Funerals. Serving others as we would like to be served. Commercial Bank of West Liberty, where friendliness prevails. By J.W. Wood and Quality Staves in Wallingford. And by U.S. Bank. All of us serving you.
Hi, everyone, and welcome in to this edition of Inside Morehead State Basketball from the campus of Morehead State University, and today from the Academic Athletic Center. As always, alongside the interim head coach of the Eagles, Preston Spradlin, I'm David Patrick. And Preston, it's not often in a college basketball game that two teams on the same night crack the century mark, but it happened last Wednesday night, Murray State and Morehead here on this court.
Yeah, what a special night. What a great college basketball game. You know, the OVC is known for a lot of storied programs, and then certainly Murray State and Morehead State are two of those programs that trademark our great basketball league. So anytime that we get together, it's always a great game. It's a close game. It's exciting with great players on each side and great fan bases. So just really glad that we came out on the right side of that one, and a high-scoring affair in front of a terrific crowd, and just a great college basketball game.
Big show for you today. We'll have highlights of the Eagles game against Southeast Missouri on the road. Also highlights of the road game at Eastern Kentucky University. But first, Morehead State's big win over Murray State here at Johnson Arena. That's next on Inside Morehead State Basketball. Preston, good to see the students out in full force in the game against Murray.
Yeah, you know, really special. That's what the thing's all about here, is our community and our students and our campus community coming out and supporting their team. So really exciting when you get a great crowd like that of coming out and just watching their team get after it, and a great college basketball game like we mentioned before. And just how exciting, you know, Trey Shaw got in some foul trouble, but still played a really good game with the minutes that he did get in there. And there, Miguel getting out. That was off a block shot right there, as a matter of fact. And got the break going and getting Miguel out. And Sprite commercial right there. My man getting hung on the rim. Our guys staying with it, kick ahead. And again, Trey with an extra pass. Look at this ball movement. Just guys playing free and loose and sharing the ball, making it a lot of fun to watch this team out here.
Preston, you grabbed the momentum early. You really came out of the gate and established a tempo.
We did. You know, our guys, they come out, they're fired up. They understood that this was a big game. They were excited with the crowd and everyone who was there. Of course, the blue out, wearing the blue uniforms. And I thought we really just executed on both ends. We were talking defensively, and offensively we were just clicking. We were aggressive, playing inside to out, whether we were posting the ball or whether we were driving and kicking it out. And you're kind of seeing that there. This play right here, Lamontre with a great post up, and Jordan coming up with an extra possession for us, and Lamontre just unconscious, doesn't care that he just missed a shot. He'll step outside and use his versatility to make you pay on that one. And I tell you, Xavier picked up two early fouls, only played 4 minutes in the first half, so Miguel ran the point for us and did a really good job, as you see there, attacking off ball screens and getting Ronnie a great look. Taekwon again with some terrific minutes for us. I thought he was spectacular in the game, chasing rebounds, getting some putbacks, and then finishing a couple different post-ups for us with his back to the basket, which he's really talented to do. End of the half right there, Miguel getting the ball and pushing it, making a really nice play for Ty. And then, so we go into the half with a lot of momentum, a lot of excitement, and give Murray State credit, a very good team, very good players. So they came out in the second half and they did the things they needed to do to make a good ball game of it. That was the first play of the half right there, great execution basically out of a timeout. And coming down in transition, these guys just using shot fakes and coming to 2 feet, making sure they're playing with great fundamentals and making the game look easy. Rico just leading the break right there off a rebound and then following it up. And you just see that intensity that he brings with us every single day that just makes him so special and is contagious with our team. And then this guy got going a little bit. I think he finished with 18 points, and he was scoreless in the first half. He had a turnover and then two fouls, but he didn't let it faze him. He came out, and these two guys together are just absolutely electric. They're fearless out there. They play bigger than what they are. They take shots. They make shots. They make plays that other people can't play, and I'm really proud of the way they do. But then here come the Racers. You know, Jonathan Stark, I think he finished with 33 points, a really good player for them, one of the leading scorers in the league here. Again, Ronnie, look at that. Beautiful play, no look pass, and to Ronnie finished the game with 7 points, 7 assists, 8 rebounds, and a steal. Just a terrific game for him, and then played some unbelievable defense as well. Xavier actually called that play on the fly. We were going to play for Trey to come up and screen, but Xavier just liked his matchup with Rico's man again better and made that play. And Ronnie, that's what he does right there. Well, there's 2 of his 8 rebounds. That was off a free throw, and that was a huge basket for us after we had executed and got fouled and missed a free throw, and he just stayed with it. And again, these guys just relentless, especially on the offensive glass, getting us extra possessions and playing with a lot of excitement, and so that makes it fun. Again, Murray, just a really good team. This kid got it going. Terrell Miller, terrific inside-out player. He really shot the ball well, finished with 27 points for them. So, you know, some things that we have to make some adjustments going forward. And end of regulation, got a good look right there with Xavier. That's something we've worked on. And, you know, good shot, didn't get it, so extra basketball. The fans are going to get a little more for their money. Rico keeping his dribble alive right here after they do a good job defending the play, so it becomes one-on-one, and we really like our chances with him one-on-one with anybody in our league. And again, Terrell Miller off a ball screen right there. Just great execution by Murray. It's what good teams do.
Preston, it didn't seem like he missed a shot the entire night.
He's a good player. You know, good player. And give them credit. They made the shots they needed to keep the game close. And then again, this guy got it going. Great screening on the baseline in that particular play for him. Again, you're going to see it right here. Same type of action. There it is. Rico with a great screen. It's not going to show up in the stat sheet, but it's certainly going to show up when we show our team the things that help us win a game like this, and that's a big part of it. This is a big play here, turnover down the stretch. I felt like we were up, I think, 6, and with a little over a minute to go, we had 2 crucial turnovers against the press. Then we get to the last play of the game after Xavier had fouled out. Miguel had almost turned the ball over the play before this. I looked at him. I said, go win the game for us. Forget about that last play. Go win the game for us. Execute. And that's exactly what he did. And we've said on this show before and talked about what a clutch player he is. He's had multiple game-winning plays since he's been here at Morehead State. And then finishing the game with great discipline right here. Didn't foul, so we're up by 1. We obviously don't want to give them any open look. So keeping everybody in front, making sure that we contest whatever shot they get. And then, you know, just a great feeling right there when you walk away with that win. And you don't play all the way. You know, you didn't play a complete game. You had some mistakes, and a good team fought back. But we found a way to win down the stretch. And I just want to make sure I address the crowd after that, because they play such a huge role in our success when we play here at home. Our guys really feed off that energy that they provide. And I'm really excited with our fan base right now. And any part that I can play for as long as I can do it in reigniting the special fan base that we have here at Morehead State, I want to make sure that I continue to do that, because they deserve a great brand of basketball each and every year.
Stay with us when we come back. Highlights of Morehead State's big road win at Southeast Missouri. That's next on Inside Morehead State Basketball.
Moon to descent. Another 3. You might want to guard him. 13 consecutive points.
Preston, anytime you go on the road, it's tough.
It was, and, you know, SEMO, they did a great job of getting a promotion out. I think it was like a Hall of Fame night for them. They had it was a red out, you know, so they gave out like 3,000-some T-shirts that night. And so our guys were excited. That gave a little extra edge going into the game. And, you know, they started the game the entire first half. They played this kind of a run-and-jump zone where they were going to trap Xavier or Miguel, whoever had the ball, and then they were going to face guard the other one. So they were going to force us to beat them with guys like Ronnie and Rico. Rico, and I tell you, I was just so proud of them because they looked at each other. Xavier looked at it at Ronnie, and he said, "Why don't you get 30 tonight? Maybe it's not a night that I need to score. This is for you. Won't you go out here and play your game?" And Ronnie was terrific. And Jordan coming off the bench. We know we didn't get into our bench that much that night. We only played seven guys. Part of that is because we were really locked in defensively. And how about that right there? Just an extra pass. And what doesn't get enough credit for that is Rico taking a bounce towards the middle of the floor, drawing Ronnie's defender, and Ronnie being down and ready to knock down that shot. I think Ronnie had a career-high 14 points. We had all five starters scoring in double figures. And how about that? Driving, sharing the ball, Trayshad ready to deliver that. I thought Rico was absolutely terrific in this game, 24 points, 12 rebounds, and 5 assists. Then they went man-to-man in the second half, and that's when our team had a chance to have a little fun. Xavier Moon coming off and doing what he does in that flat ball screen action. Such a threat. The very next play, here he comes down again, just recognizes what he has. And that is not coaching right there. That is a great player making a great play, and that's why Xavier's so special. And if it looks a whole lot like what you just saw, it's because that's what it is. And they defend it differently. Xavier makes an adjustment, splits the ball screen to a floater, and that's stuff that NBA guys do right there.
Preston, if this guy is not first-team All-OVC, nobody is.
Yeah, you're right about that. He might be first-team All-SEC because we only and he probably should be. How about this kid? Should be All-Newcomer team. He's terrific. Jordan Walker came in. He had 12 minutes and had 6 points, two big threes, and played some great defense. Again, Rico, look at that pace, spin move, counter move, getting to 2 feet, finishing with that hook. That's beautiful basketball by him. I just thought they all played terrific that night. And, you know, again, this is where this little guy gets going. Miguel starts on a run. He goes, scores 14 in a row for us. He was scoreless in the first half. He recognized what he took, what the defense gave him. We called a couple plays for him, as you're seeing here. Again, the screening on the baseline. Miguel getting in there, making a play, getting separation. He really had it going, and that was really fun to watch on the road when a guy goes 14 in a row and the other team just has no answer for it. Again, right here, using screens, reading screens, Xavier making a great play, shot fake. It's fun to watch. I mean, these guys, they're so much fun to coach. We're enjoying playing with each other. And as you can see the score, we're still down. So a good SEMO team. They're fighting. They're scrapping. Miguel right there, shot fake, take the presence of mind to stay behind the three and take the three and give us the lead right there. That was a huge, huge play. So the game's in the balance. We're fighting, struggling right now. And
guess who?
Getting out in transition and, you know, Xavier finding Miguel, and he had the hot hand. And just here comes a trap. Rico making himself available. Extra pass. Trey finishing the play. And look at that bench. That blue bench just exploding over there. That's why we do this. It makes it so special. And come out of there with a road win. Anytime you do a road win is special. And to do it in the fashion that we did was really a lot of fun.
Morehead State gets the win at SEMO, 89-81. Stay with us when we come back. You don't want to miss this. Highlights of the Eagles game at EKU at McBrayer Arena in Richmond. That's next on Inside Morehead State Basketball.
Must have discipline. You know that. Constant key for us. You guys are really doing a good job with it. Stay on our feet on closeouts. Don't reach, all that stuff. Have discipline, but you must be focused. You're on the road, good crowd. It's not the same game that it was last time. We care about the guys in this room, the things on this board, and how we prepare for this game. Let's execute. Let's go ahead and take care of this.
8 to shoot, Marrero left wing. On the drive on Mayo to the lane. Kick out right side, Beeman. 3 to shoot, Ronnie. Baseline runner. Off the glass and in from 5 out. Now the handoff to Moon out top to the right side. Miguel the center moves down the wing. Down low. Williams wide open for the right-hand layup. Right side, descent, around for a three. Back of the iron, no. Marrero taps the rebound to himself. Back to the hole with the left hand, missed it. Williams, offensive rebound, baseline left, off the glass and in. Moon comes around, takes the handoff. Back to the hash, descent. Skips it right of the lane, Marrero, to his left. The hook from 5, got it. Cross court, right half, descent. Right elbow, Harris. He'll put it to the deck, kick to the left corner. Walker will shoot the three, switch. Off to the right hash and Walker. Walker holding, looking. Right to Glenn Marrero. Turns right. Off the glass and in with a hook from 7. Right block rebound. Beeman on the run. Morehead State Moon. Moon at the left sideline. Pull up, jump and shoot for 3. Got it. Xavier with five, and Morehead State leads 20-18. They can't run with MSU. Moon on the drive, bounce right side, descent, coming baseline right, down low, baseline left, Moon with the lefty layup, Batum. Tyquan trying to back his man in, throws behind the back feed, knocked away, but picked off by Moon between the circles. Left wing Walker, open from 3-point land, got it! Left wing Moon. Moon turns right, comes top of the key, high right descent, right corner Walker, he'll shoot the three, yes sir! Jordan with nine, and Morehead State leads 28-22. Right hash, Walker, trap, leaves it back outside the half. Moon, cross court, wide left descent. He'll angle in, dish down low. Harris knocked away from him. Bidding comes up with it. He'll lay it home. Tyquan fought for the ball and got his 2 points, his first two of the night. Moon at the timeline, checking interim head coach Preston Spradlin for the play. 21 to shoot, wide right. Moon, three ball, yeah! 35-27, Morehead State. MSU man-to-man. He'll run high right, back out to Mayo. Now stolen by Marrero. Here comes Rico, coast-to-coast with a two-hand slammeroo. Out front to Marrero. Left to right comes the X-Man for the ball. He'll drive right up the lane. He'll block to the goal. Runner from the baseline with one hand, it's in. 14 for Xavier. Looking over the traffic, Xavier Moon coming top of the key. Backs it up to Marrero. Rico kick high right, descent, wide left Moon. Moon, down low, baseline left, Williams, a bounce, a hook, it's in. McGlone shoots the three, up the iron, off the glass, Moon the board for Morehead State, down the floor, right wing descent. He'll shoot the three, yes sir! Nope, 48-43 Morehead, descent at the right wing, dancing, coming down the baseline. Fade and fire from 16, it'll rattle and go. Miguel descent, on McGlone. Miguel spins a pass out. 19-footer. Rico Marrero got it. High left. Moon to the offensive end with it. Moon on the drive right in the lane. Dish out wide left Harris. He'll spin to his left. The one-hander from five. Got it. Baseline left. Marrero kicks it out high right to set. Miguel on the drive to his left. Pull up. Fade away. Free throw line. Jumper. Got it. Moon floats to his right. Off the Marrero pick. Comes left to the lane. Out front Harris. Straight away. Three swish! Runs to the left hash, back to his right. Wide left descent. Descent on Avare. Miguel on the drive. The runner from five. Back of the rim and in. Six. Morehead State leads 67-62. Avare. Pitch back to Gist. 8 seconds to go. Wide left. He'll shoot the three. Off the iron. Top of the glass. No. Rebound tip. Beeman has it to Moon. 1 second to go, down the floor to the set. The game is over, and Morehead State hangs on for a tough victory here tonight in Richmond. And the Eagles win their fourth straight and their 11th in 14 games as they come away with a 67-62 triumph over Eastern Kentucky.
Well, it means a lot, you know, obviously to our fans, the rivalry game, so it's got a little added stuff to it. So to play on a Saturday night, to come up here and get a road win is very, very nice. And so now we got to go back. We got to get prepared for a really tough road swing down at Tennessee State and Belmont. They're just a fun group of guys, and they're having fun playing basketball, and why not? That's why we all play it. That's why I coach it. This isn't like work. So they're playing with great confidence, and, you know, the guys had turned the ball over tonight. They're not looking over at the bench wondering if they're coming out. They're getting it back for us on defense, and I trust them to make those types of plays, and they trust that I'm going to let them go out there and continue doing what they're going to do. That's where that confidence comes from. It's all them, and they're having fun playing basketball.
Thank you so much for watching this week on Inside Morehead State Basketball. And a quick note, big week for you. Thursday night at Tennessee State, nationally televised game on ESPNU, and then Saturday, big rematch with Belmont in Nashville.
Yeah, something our guys have had circled on the calendar. They're looking forward to making that tough Nashville swing, accepting the challenge of going on the road, and seeing if we can take care of business.
On behalf of the Morehead State interim coach, Preston Spradlin, I'm David Patrick, and we will see you next Sunday right here on Inside Morehead State Basketball.
Inside Morehead State Basketball was brought to you by Jack Rowe Insurance, your independent agent serving all your insurance needs. the Citizens Bank of Morehead, the home of totally free checking. Larry Fannin Chevrolet, Buick, and GMC. Richard White Wood Products, a premier exporter of Kentucky hardwoods worldwide. Lakeside Christian Academy, located on US 60 West in Morehead. Educating for eternity. Visit us online at lakesidechristianacademy.org. Stand for Builders Paving and Sealing of West Liberty. Professional work at low prices. That's how we roll. The Tim Short Auto Group. Take the short drive to satisfaction. Northcutt & Son Home for Funerals. Serving others as we would like to be served. Commercial Bank of West Liberty, where friendliness prevails. By J.W. Wood and Quality Staves in Wallingford. And by U.S. Bank. All of us serving you.